Hi, Carl Winkler here at Lectrosonics. The D2 digital wireless mic system employs powerful AES 256-bit CTR encryption, the gold standard for robust ciphers, and offers three different key policies, including universal, shared, and standard. In this video, I'll cover the differences between them and explain how to set up the system with each. When transmitting audio, there are situations where privacy is essential, such as during professional sporting events, in courtrooms, private meetings, or government institutions. In the D2 system, high-entropy encryption keys are first created in the DSQD receiver. The key is then sent to encryption-capable digital transmitters via the infrared port. The audio is thus encoded and can only be decoded if both the receiver and associated transmitters have a matching key. Okay, let's consider the three different key policy types available in the D2 system. The universal key type provides the most convenient option and is the default setting on D2 transmitters and receivers. A unique key does not have to be generated for each situation. Simply set the transmitters and receiver to universal key type and the encryption is in place. This prevents someone with a scanner and digital demodulator from decoding the audio, but not as secure as creating a unique key. The shared key policy is useful when you need multiple transmitters and receivers all connected, but require more security than the universal type, for instance, in sports coverage. Once a shared key is generated by the DSQD and transferred to a transmitter, the key is then available to be shared by that transmitter with other transmitters and receivers via their infrared ports, making this a flexible tool. The standard key policy offers the highest level of security. A unique key is created in the DSQD that is then shared with its transmitters, but cannot be shared transmitter to receiver, or receiver to receiver. An additional key policy you might notice listed in the DBU and DHU transmitter menus is the volatile type. Although the DSQD receiver does not offer a matching key policy, the DBU and DHU can be used with the older DR digital receiver. With the volatile key policy in place, when a transmitter is turned off or the battery is replaced, the key is lost, and a new one must be generated in the receiver, then transferred to the transmitters. Okay, so let's go through the process of setting up the key policy for each type, generating the keys, and then syncing up our transmitters. First off, both your transmitters and receiver must be set to the same key policy. If you see key mismatch on one or more of your receiver channels, even though the frequency looks correct and you're getting RF but no audio, this is the reason why. For the universal key, if you haven't changed the default settings from the factory, there's nothing else you need to do. The components in the D2 system, including the DSQD, the DBU, the DHU, and any future units, already have the key and are set to this policy by default. If the policy has been changed, you can manually reset it in the receiver by going to the infrared sync and encryption menu, choosing encryption key management, selecting universal as the key type, then pressing menu select to confirm, then OK. In the transmitter, scroll in the menu down to key type, then use the arrows to select universal, again resetting either the transmitter or receiver to default settings will also return the key policy to universal. With the key policy set to shared in both your transmitters and your receiver, now you must generate a new key and transfer that key from the receiver to the transmitters you plan to use. First, select the key type by navigating to Encryption Key Management, then selecting Shared as the key type, then pressing Menu Select to confirm, then OK. You'll see a message indicating that now you must generate a key. To do this, use the arrows to highlight the Create Key button, then press Menu Select to proceed. There will be a note that all transmitters associated with this DSQD will require a new key. Move the cursor to OK and press Menu Select to confirm. Now, along with syncing transmitters with frequency information, we must also send them the key before the channels will work. In the IR Sync and Encryption menu, navigate to Sync Key and press Menu Select. The Send Key button is highlighted. Now hold the transmitter up to the IR window and press Menu Select twice to blow the key into the transmitter. Don't forget, the transmitter also needs to be set to shared key. From here, additional receivers that are also set to the shared key policy can get the key from this transmitter. On those units, navigate to Sync Key, but now use the arrows to select Get Key and press Menu Select. The receiver will wait for the transmitter to send the key. The way to do this is to move down in the main menu of the transmitter past Key Type, past Wipe Key, to Send Key. Press Menu Select, and you'll see the word Share with an arrow pointing to the up arrow button. Hold the transmitter IR window close to the receiver IR window, and press the up button. You should see Success on the receiver, and you're all set. With the key policy set to standard, like with shared, you must first generate a new key, then send it to the associated transmitters. Start by selecting the key type in the transmitter to standard. Next, navigate to the IR sync and encryption in the receiver, then select standard, followed by menu select to confirm, then OK. Next, generate a key the same way you did with the shared setting. So the main difference between shared and standard is that now the key developed in the DSQD can only be sent to the transmitters being used directly with it. It can't be shared via transmitter to any other devices. In fact, while in standard, a transmitter does not show Send Key in the menu. With any of the above methods, once you have set it up and turn on your transmitter's RF, you'll see all green on the receiver channel indicators. You are good to go. As you can see, the D2 digital wireless system offers three different encryption key management policies for the powerful AES 256-bit CTR encryption. For details about this feature, please download the DSQD manual from Lectrosonics.com. On the website, you'll also find our white paper on encryption. I'm Carl Winkler. Thanks for watching.